Hallelujah. Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the presence of the Lord. Let us pray. Father, this morning we give you all the glory. We give you all the praise. We give you all the adoration. We thank you for your faithfulness, for your mercies, for securing us, for preserving each one of us and our immediate family. We want to thank you, Lord, for the privilege to be in your presence one more time this morning. Take all the glory it has been by your spirit that has made it possible for us to see this day. We thank you, Lord, for it. This morning, Father, as we commune and have fellowship with you, our prayer is that, Father, you speak to us by your word. You said your sheep knows your word. They know you and the voice of a stranger they will not follow. So, Father, this morning, speak to us. Empower us with divine abilities for the work that you have put in our hands this morning. As we go about our duties this morning, we ask for your manifested presence to be with us in everything that we do, that the name of our Lord Jesus Christ will be glorified. In Jesus' mighty name, amen.
Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. We thank God for yet another time in his presence this morning. Said, I laid me down and slept. I awoke because the Lord sustained me. Father, we thank you this morning. We bless your name. Let's worship the King of Kings together this morning.
Hallelujah. 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 Oh. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Eh. Hallelujah.
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 Before the Lord in prayers this morning, as we do always do, let's have Pastor Jibril lead us today.
Hallelujah. I welcome you once more into God's presence this morning, even as we pray. Hallelujah. Our first prayer this morning. Father, thank you for being my God and the power and the owner of my life. Therefore, Father, I come humbly and boldly before your throne of grace today to be merciful unto me and receive my person. I'd like us to lift up our voices this morning and begin to appreciate him and bless his name. Father, in the name of Jesus, I worship you once more. And I thank you, Lord, for you are my creator. I bless your name, O Lord, for you own me. My life belongs to you. You said in your word, therefore, let us come boldly to the throne of grace that we may obtain mercy and find grace in our time of need. Lord, I've come before you to obtain mercy and find grace this morning in the name of Jesus. I thank you, Lord, for your faithfulness, for your mercies, for your grace upon my life. I thank you, O Lord, for all that you have done for me. Lord, your word says, for this God is our God forever and ever, for he will be our guide even unto the dead. Lord, I worship you for being my God, and forever, ever and ever you'll be my God in the name of Jesus. And you will guide me even unto death. I worship you. I worship you, King of Kings. I magnify and glorify your holy name, O Lord, for there's none like you. Thank you, Jesus, for today. Thank you, O Lord, for all that you have done for me, in the mighty name of Jesus, we have given thanks. Hallelujah. Our next prayer this morning. Father, continue to cleanse me by the power of your word so I can live a life.
Mr. Amino,
yes.
Please check what you opened.
April 8th. 9th. I apologize for that.
What's today's date?
April 9th. I apologize for that.
So let's start.
Hallelujah. Our first prayer for today. Father, thank you for today, the day you and only you have made. I received the gift of today, and I thank you for it. Lift up your voice once more and appreciate him and bless his name. Thank him for the gift of life. Thank you for a day like this that he has given us to be glad and rejoicing. Father, we thank you. We bless your name. We glorify you and magnify your holy name. Thank you, O Lord, according to your word, that this is the day which the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. We are gathered before you to rejoice and be glad in you, O Lord. Thank you for your faithfulness. Thank you for the gift of life. Thank you for your mercies and your grace. Thank you, O Lord, for keeping us and guiding us and being with us, Lord, in all that we do. We have come to glorify you. We have come to magnify you. We have come to bless your name, O Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we have given thanks. Hallelujah. Our next prayer this morning. Father, let every barrier on my path of completeness be crushed and destroyed in this year of completeness. Hallelujah. Lift up your voice and speak to the Lord. Lift up your voice. Lord, in the name of Jesus, any barrier of the enemy in my path, O Lord, to my completeness, O Lord, this year, according to the word that you have spoken to us, Lord, I ask, O Lord, that such barrier be destroyed in the name of Jesus Christ. Your word says, thus say the Lord to his anointed, to Cyrus, whose right hand I have holden, to subdue nations before him. And I will loose the loins of kings to open before him the two-leveled gates, and the gates shall not be shut. I will go before thee and make the crooked place straight. I will break in pieces the gates of brass and cut in sunder the bars of iron. Lord, go ahead of me today. Go ahead of me today. Lord, and break every gate, every barrier that have been placed to my completeness this year in the name of Jesus. Let it be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Go ahead of me, O Lord, and make the crooked places straight for me in the name of Jesus. Make the crooked places straight for me in the name of Jesus. You said in your word that you break in pieces the gates of brass and cut in sunder the bars of iron. Lord, it is my year of completeness, O Lord. Go ahead of me and do that which you said you would do according to your word to me in the name of Jesus. Go ahead of me, O Lord. Go ahead of me, O Lord. Loose the loins of kings for me, O Lord. Open before me, O Lord, the two-leveled gates in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Our next prayer. Father, today I ask that you specially baptize me with the spirit of dedication resulting in breakthrough order of testimonies in my life. Hallelujah. Lift up your voice and speak to the Lord. Father, I ask that you baptize me today specially. Baptize me with the spirit of dedication, O Lord. Oh, dedication resulting in breakthrough order of testimonies. Lord, let this breakthrough result in testimonies, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. Oh, Lord, you said in your word, if any man serve me, let him follow me. Where I am, there shall also my servant be. If any man serve me, he will my Father honor. Lord, in the name of Jesus, give me the grace, O Lord. Give me the grace to be dedicated fully unto you, to serving you in the name of Jesus. That will result in testimonies day by day. Order of testimonies, O Lord, in my life in the name of Jesus. Baptize me specially, O Lord. Baptize me, O Lord, to be dedicated, O Lord, to serving you, Lord. Lord, faithfully in the name of Jesus, resulting in breakthrough. Breakthrough of testimonies in my life in the name of Jesus. Give me the grace today, Lord. Baptize me, O Lord, with the spirit of dedication. Baptize me, O Lord, with the spirit of dedication this day. In the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, I ask for grace resulting, O Lord, in breakthrough of testimonies in my life. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Our next prayer. Also, Father, today I'm asking that you specially baptize me with passion for souls. making me wiser and richer in my walk with you day by day. Lift up your voice and speak to the Lord. Lift up your voice. Father, oh Lord, I ask. You said, oh Lord, in your word, that the fruit of righteousness is a tree of life, and he that winneth souls is wise. Lord, you said also that they that be wise shall shine as the brightness of the firmament, and they that turn many to righteousness are the stars, as the stars forever and ever. I ask in the name of Jesus Christ that you put in me a passion, baptize me with passion for souls, oh Lord. Let the desire, oh Lord, for the lust be in my heart, oh Lord, making me wiser and richer in my walk with you day by day in the name of Jesus. You said in your word, oh Lord, he that winneth souls is wise, oh Lord. Fill me, oh Lord, with passion. Fill me, oh Lord, with love for the lost in the name of Jesus. Lord, let your passion be my passion, oh Lord. Let me chase them, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus. Empower me, oh Lord. Baptize me, oh Lord, with grace, oh Lord, with passion for the lost in the name of Jesus. He said, you had did I turn many to righteousness? Those that turn many to righteousness as the stars, they shall shine as stars forever and ever. Lord, let me shine as a star in the name of Jesus forever and ever, making me wiser, richer in my walk with you in the name of Jesus. Give me grace, oh Lord. Give me passion. Baptize me with passion for the lost in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Our next prayer. Father, empower me with the spirit of love so I can continue to love your word until it becomes my way of life. Lift up your voice and speak to the Lord. Father, I ask this morning that you empower me, O Lord, with the spirit of love. Lord, put in me, O Lord, a desire, a love for your word, O Lord, day by day. Let me desire it. Let it fill my heart, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. Pour, Lord, your spirit upon me, your spirit of love, O Lord, that I would desire to spend time to study your word in the name of Jesus. How I love thy law. It is my meditation all day. Hallelujah. Though through thy commandments hast thou made me wiser than my enemies, for they are ever with me. I have more understanding than all my teachers. For thy testimonies are my meditation. I understand more than the ancient because I keep their precepts. Lord, I ask in the name of Jesus, empower me with your love, oh Lord, that I'll continue to love to meditate in your word, to spend time studying your word in the name of Jesus. Lord, empower me with the spirit of love in the name of Jesus, that your word become a way of life, will become a part of life for me in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Our next prayer. Father, by the power of the Holy Ghost, grant me supernatural utterance that will prick the heart of every unsaved soul unto repentance as I minister to them. Lift up your voice in prayer. My God and my Father, I'm asking, Lord, that you give me what to say. Give me what to say, O Lord, even as I speak to those, O Lord, you have sent me to in the name of Jesus. Those unsaved souls, give me what to say, oh Lord. Give me utterance, oh Lord. Give me utterance, oh Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, give me the words to say that will prick the heart of every unsaved soul unto repentance in the mighty name of Jesus. Give me, Lord, utterance in the mighty name of Jesus. He said, now, when they heard this, they were pricked in their hearts. And said unto Peter and to the rest of the apostles, men and brethren, what shall we do? Hallelujah. Then Peter said unto them, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the remission of sins, and ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. I ask, O Lord, in the name of Jesus, you give me supernatural utterance, Lord, even as I minister to the unsaved, O Lord. Give me supernatural utterance that will prick the heart of every unsaved soul unto repentance in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Our next prayer. Father, empower me to lay down what is required so I can take delivery of all that you have reserved for me in life. lift up your voice once more and begin to speak to the Lord. Ask him for grace, to lay down that which is required. My God and my Father, I'm asking today that if there's anything in my life that I'm holding on to that I'm not supposed to, Lord, empower me to lay it down. Empower me to lay it down. Empower me to lay down that which is required, oh Lord, that I can take delivery. I can take hold of that which you have reserved for me in this life, in my life, in the name of Jesus. I ask, oh Lord, for grace. I ask, oh Lord, for spirit of obedience, oh Lord, to lay down that which is required in the name of Jesus. You said, oh Lord, therefore, that my Father loved me because I laid down my life, that I take it again. No man take it from me, but I lay it down of myself. I have power to lay it down and I have power to take it again. This commandment I have received from my Father. Hallelujah. Lord, give me grace, even as Jesus laid down his life for me. Give me the grace to lay down that which is required, that I can take delivery of that which you have reserved for me in the name of Jesus. You said also in your word, he that had my commandment and kept them, it is he that loved me. And he that loved me shall be loved of thy Father, of my Father. And I will love him and I will manifest myself to him. Lord, I ask in the name of Jesus, help me to keep to your commandment, O Lord. Help me to keep to your commandments, O Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Give me the grace, O Lord, the strength to lay down that which is required, that I can take delivery of that which you have reserved for me, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Finally, this morning, Father, anoint me afresh with the oil of gladness so I can make the most of my kingdom advancement endeavors with unending rewards. Lift up your voice and pray. Pray like you mean it. Pray unto the Lord. Father, anoint me this morning afresh. Anoint me afresh with the oil of gladness in the name of Jesus. Anoint me, O Lord, with the oil of gladness, O Lord, so I can make most of my kingdom advancement endeavors with unending rewards, day by day. You said in your word, though the fig tree does not blossom, neither shall the fruit be in the vines, the laborers of the olive shall fail. The labor of the olive shall fail. Hallelujah. And the field shall yield no meat. The flock shall be cut off from the fold, and there shall be no herd in the stalls. Yet I will rejoice in the Lord. I will joy in the God of my salvation. The Lord God is my strength. He will make my feet like hen feet, and he will make me walk upon my high places. Lord, I ask in the name of Jesus, even though things will not walk the way I want them to walk, I will yet praise you, Lord. Put that gladness, fill me with that oil of gladness so I can serve you, O Lord, faithfully, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. Fill me, O Lord, with the afresh, O Lord. Anoint me afresh with the oil of gladness in the mighty name of Jesus to make most of my kingdom advancement endeavors with unending rewards. So let me serve you faithfully with joy in my heart, day by day, in the name of Jesus. Father, we worship you and bless your name. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for answering the prayers this morning. In the mighty name of Jesus, we have prayed. Hallelujah.
Amen. Father, we thank you. Very quickly, let's go to the reading of the scriptures this morning. We'll be reading from 1 Peter chapter 5, verses 1 to 11. 1 Peter chapter 5, verses 1 to 11. And Sister Evelyn from Seattle will read for us.
Good morning. 1 Peter 5, 1 to 11. The elders which are among you I exhort, who am also an elder and a witness of the sufferings of Christ, and also a partaker of the glory that shall be revealed. Feed the flock of God, which is among you, taking the oversight thereof, not by constraint, but willingly, not for filthy lucre, but of a ready mind, neither as being lords over God's heritage, but being and samples to the flock. 4. And when the chief shepherd shall appear, ye shall receive a crown of glory that fadeth not away. Likewise, ye younger, submit yourselves unto the elder, yea, all of you by subject one to another, and be clothed with humility. For God resisteth the proud and giveth grace to the humble. 6. Humble yourselves, therefore, under the mighty hand of God, that he may exalt you in due time, casting all your care upon him, for he careth for you. 8. Be sober and vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about, seeking whom he may devour. Whom resist steadfast in the faith, knowing that the same afflictions are accomplished in your brethren that are in the world. 10. But the God of all grace, who hath called us unto his eternal glory by Christ Jesus, after that ye have suffered a while, make you perfect, establish, strengthen, settle you. 11. To him be glory and dominion forever and ever. Amen.
Amen. Glory to God. Thank God for his word again this morning. Looking at what gets us answers in prayers, which is essentially praying according to God's will. The Bible says this is the confidence that we have in him. If we ask anything according to his will, then he hears us. And if we know that he hears us, whatsoever we ask, we know that we have received that petition. If we ask anything according to his will, that's the goal. Remember, if it's according to his will, it means it is according to his word, because his will and his word are the same. And that's why Jesus said, if you abide in me and my words abide in you, then you shall ask what you will. It shall be done unto you, because he knows. It is in praying it according to his word. It is in doing the word, living the word, that brings us answers in prayer. God's will is stated in God's word. So let's go for it. Not the stories of men, not the teachings of philosophers that makes it appear that's, you know, it makes religious sense. No, it has to be as stated by his word, which is his will. And in the light of that, there are very, very specific things that God has told us to do, which in doing them grant us answers or connects us with answers when we pray. I've showed us one, John 15, verse 16, you have not chosen me, but I have chosen you, and I've ordained you that you go and bring fruit, and that your fruit should remain. Then whatsoever you shall ask the Father in my name, he may give it to you. Significant. We've talked about that. I will show you another one today, which is also very significant, because I think the past 2 days I talked to Ross about the faith dimension very quickly, that because you prayed it and you've not seen it, and then, or you're talking against what you have prayed and all those things, there's no faith, it doesn't work. But the one I'm talking about today, or one of the ones, is we just read it from 1 Peter 5, verse 7. It's a casting all your cares upon him, for he cares for you. Many read it, but there's a significant word there that we don't pay attention to. The way many read it is cast your cares upon him, he cares. That is, whichever one you want to cast to him. perhaps the cares of life, anxieties, worries. Tomorrow, what's going to happen next? Worries. Where am I going to get this? How am I going to do that? After you are afraid, continues to nullify your prayers. Just people pray, but don't get answers the way they should because of all these points. The Bible didn't say just cast some bodies on him or just cast some cares. He said, no, casting all. Casting all your care upon him. Casting all your care upon him. If you are going to have any confidence that God will hear you in prayer, you must pray in line with the word. That's what guarantees answer. This is the confidence that we have in him. If we ask anything according to his will, then he hears us. If not according to his will, he's not hearing. So it isn't his will to give you grace to bear your bodies. No. He said, cast them all on me. When he has already said, cast them all on me, and you are praying, Lord, just help me to bear them. It doesn't work that way. Casting them all, not some, not a few, casting them all. It's not to take away some, no, casting them all, casting all your care upon him because God cares. It's very important to know that means stop worrying. That's what it means. I always tell people, if they say they will kill you tomorrow, don't die today, that will be suicide. Stop worrying. Let tomorrow come first. Stop worrying. Stop worrying because God cares for you. Let me read that verse in the Amplified Version. It says, casting the whole of your care, all your anxieties, all your worries, all your concerns, once and for all, on him. For he cares for you affectionately and cares about you watchfully. Cast it all on him. That's why the Bible says, be careful for nothing, Philippians 4:6. Be careful for nothing, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your request be known unto God. Be careful for nothing. Be anxious, another translation says. Be anxious about nothing. Pray to him, cast it all on him, with thanksgiving. He said, verse 7, and the peace of God, which passes all understanding, shall keep your heart. That means it keeps your heart from worrying. Your heart and minds. Through Jesus Christ. It keeps it from worrying. You pray it and you are still worrying about it. It doesn't work that way. When you pray it, you leave it to him. When you pray it, you leave it to him. I give us another one quickly just to be touching them. This concerning financial blessing, because everybody falls into this narrative. But remember, we read 3 John in the course of this teaching, verse 2, beloved, by which above all things that thou mayest prosper and be in health, even as thy soul prospers. You remember we said that it is as your soul prospers. I can go a week long on that. Because many people don't know that. You see, when you have a seed, every seed you have, when you have a fruit in your hand, there's a seed in that fruit. And in every seed, there is life. Every seed don't have life. But seeds actually have life in them. You hold the seed, it's hard and this, but inside it is life. And let me tell you this today. The life of your seed, no matter how big or small it is the word that propels you in giving it. So when you are doing it without the word, it has no life. It's an hybrid seed. It can produce. They're not doing it in line with his will. It's an hybrid seed. It can produce. You give it, the church, wherever we take it. But everyone see it. So your soul prospers. You strengthen your giving, your tithes, your offerings, all that with the word that you have received, moving you, motivating you in doing what you are doing. And trust him. It's all in line with his will. He said, but my God shall supply all your needs according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. Many of us carry that, we prayed, but wait first. There's a reason for that. If you read that in this same Philippians 4, they have committed to his care, they have given to his care, they have given to the care of the saints. That's why he said that. If you pick that and run with it without doing what was said, you're praying a prayer that will get no answer. We quote the verse on his own without fulfilling the steps before. He started back from verse 10. But I rejoice greatly in the Lord that now at last your care of me, he said, has flourished again. Wherein you were also careful, but you lacked opportunity, he said. Now you have done it. That's flourished again. If you go to verse 14, notwithstanding, you have done well. That is what they did. That you did communicate with my affliction. That's what he said. Verse 15, now you Philippians also know that in the beginning of the gospel, when I departed from Macedonia, no church communicated with me as concerning giving and receiving, but you only. So there were people who knew what to do, what the word commands them to do, and they were doing it. That's why he said, now my God shall supply all your needs. So when we are quoting scriptures to pray, we must also fulfill the demands of that scripture that gave us that blessing. That's how to ask God according to his will. That's how to ask God according to his will. I can give giving you pinpoints like that of his will and how they connect us to answers. We don't just pray quoting scriptures. Most of those scriptures have certain conditions attached to them. When you do that, then you rise up to claim it. You rise up to pray. Let it be known I've done this according to your word. Let it be known that it is in obedience to what you commanded me that I'm doing. And that's how it goes. Time is up for me today because now we're going to go into our personal moment with God. I've seen quite some people joining for the first time today. What we do in this segment, this is the main focus of this meeting. It's a personal time for you to pray yourself before the Lord. You're already before the Lord. To pray, make it known to him the way you want. Present your request to him with joy and thanksgiving. Just celebrate him if that's all you want to do. But now you are before the Lord. And please use it effectively before him. Pray to him the issues of your life. Pray to him the anything you want to bring. You are before the Lord right now. And I know the God of heaven will hear you. And then finally we will come back together and we will close. Over to you. May God hear you this morning. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Let's begin to give him thanks. Let's begin to give him thanks. Let's begin to give him thanks. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Blessed be your name, Father. Blessed be your name, our King. Glory to your name. We thank you, Lord, this morning for receiving our persons. We bless your name, Father. Oh, what a day that is set before us again today. Knowing fully well that you have gone ahead of us. Therefore, the Lord is he that goeth before you. You have gone ahead already. We bless your name. We bless you, Lord. We celebrate you today, knowing fully well it is done already as we desired it. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Father, thank you this morning. Lord, it is in the name of Jesus that I communicate your help to everyone hearing me today. Your help. The help that proceeds. They say, we send you help from the sanctuary. Lord, I communicate your help to everyone hearing me today. As this is a month of help for us. Your help, the kind that breaks breakthrough in people's life and endeavors. Receive it today in the name of Jesus. For I will help you. Hallelujah. Lord, as all these ones go this morning, help, help. Taking us beyond our limitations by your help. In the name of Jesus. Help from above. Help from above. Whatever is holding down anything that should have been released to anyone here, let that barrier be lifted today. Let that barrier be lifted today in the name of Jesus. Let those arrows of the wicked return back to where they came. Anything targeted against the heart of anyone hearing me this morning returns back to where they come from in the name of Jesus. In the name, he said, come see the works of the Lord. What desolation he makes upon the earth. He maketh wars to cease unto the ends of the earth. Lord, every implement of warfare arranged against these ones, turn it backwards. Let it be turned backwards. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Blessed be your name. In the name of Jesus. Remember, this program runs only Monday through Friday every week. So next time we'll be back on this platform, we'll be on Monday morning, 5 a.m. Denver time. It runs on the Monday through Friday. We'll be back Monday morning, 5 a.m. I remember the announcement for next week, Thursday, the 15th. I said, I need you to text me, 918-409-3169. Your testimony of answer prayers through this morning devotion program or the impact of it in your life, but very clear, specific testimony that Thursday the 15th will be our day of testimonies, just to celebrate God, talking of his goodness and returning the glory to him. So you text me, I'm not going to take off the air call on that, and I will select. And then we'll call you on that regard. Don't text me Thursday morning. By noon on Wednesday, I should have it in. So organized and put everything in together properly. And I said, those who have texted me testimonies before, it doesn't fit into this. I just want to have a new set. Even if it's the same, I just want to have them together for this purpose. We need to celebrate God. Talk of his doings. And you remember when you share your testimony, it is said whatever you share multiplies. Apart from that, your testimony encourages all that. It becomes a tool to boost the faith of someone else, to raise others. So everything is going to fit together. And as we celebrate God with our testimonies, it will do more. That's how it is. So that's for Thursday the 15th. I need them in. Let us by Wednesday by 12 noon on Wednesday the 14th, so that I can put them together before we gather Thursday in the morning. It's going to be a great day. We'll be meeting again Monday, like I said, It runs Monday through Friday. And keep inviting people. I see some no names today also. Just keep inviting. You are doing God's service, for which he will bless you. Because it's a means by which God is bringing refreshing and strength into our lives. This morning devotion. I'm not just doing it because I want to do morning devotion. No, he told me specifically to do this. And we're putting all we can, the way we see it best fit, the narratives we are running presently. And God is helping us. So please keep inviting the people that God has a moment of encounter with you in the morning, a moment of refreshing with you in the morning, and send them the link. And if you want us to be part of that process of sending them the link, we'll do. God bless you. See you together again on Monday in the name of Jesus. Father, peace, I speak into these lives. He said, when you give quietness, who then can make trouble? I speak your quietness into these homes. There are no more trouble. I speak your quietness into these lives. No more trouble. It calms the raging waves of the sea you are. So I speak your calmness to whatever is raging against these lives. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' mighty name. Let's share the goodness together. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen. God bless you. See you in a multiplied state on Monday. Jesus is Lord.